My name is Sena Gungor, and I'll be walking you through the journey I had while creating monitoring tools for Citus on Azure. In this talk, I'll briefly explain what our most important metrics are to babysit your Postgres database and why we should keep an eye on them. To talk a little bit about myself, I'm a software engineer at Microsoft for 2 years now, and before that, I worked at Aselsan, a defense company in Turkey, and also Siemens. Before Microsoft, my relationship with databases and Postgres wasn't more than just writing SQL queries from time to time, but for the last 2 years, I'm working on Citus extension and how to serve it on Azure Cloud. And why am I giving this presentation and who is this talk for? I've been working on improving our monitoring dashboards for the use of support engineers for a while. During my work, I've noticed some good points to consider about what you need to have for the best troubleshooting experience. This talk is aimed for people new in monitoring Postgres, probably not someone who knows a lot of Postgres monitoring like Josephine Bush. She's another speaker at Citus Con. So why do we need a good monitoring tool? Whether you are using your database on-prem or with a cloud provider, you need to have information and metrics on how your database performs. One of the reasons could be root cause analysis. Once the issue is identified, the administrators need to resolve it as fast as possible. So having the necessary metrics at your fingertips is crucial. Stable monitoring and processing of application performance can help reduce outages and slowdowns because you'll be able to track your events and resource health in a reliable way. If you don't have a good monitoring setup, it means that you don't have sufficient alerts to prevent any damages to your database. Alerts are needed as a warning beforehand, and they will give you some time to take an action before anything bad happens to your database. A good monitoring tool could help you decide if you need to scale out your database or do some fine-tuning on your queries for better performance. The needs and characteristics can be very different for different types of applications, but there are some points that we could consider. Granularity of monitoring basically means how often you record the state of each metric. This needs to be handled in balance because if your metrics are reported too rapidly, you are likely to run into performance issues with huge amount of metrics flowing and a huge impact on longer term to store that data. However, if you have a 5 minute break between every report or even 30 seconds, could cause you to lose some critical information because you won't be able to pinpoint the exact timestamp of the issue. So this is all about balancing between pros and cons to decide how granular you want your metrics to be. Make sure to emit your metrics at all times. If a customer comes across an issue where they see a high CPU on their machine, and when you check your metrics to find out only that you don't have the data for the exact timeline of the issue, this creates a whole new bag of questions. So this means proactive monitoring is always better than reactive monitoring. Watching over your database constantly can minimize the downtime and breakdowns. You may need to look for any patterns occurring from time to time, so you need to have your metrics lasting for a while, depending on your needs. If you're only keeping data for the last week and you're investigating a case that is recurring every week, then you're probably missing the most important part of your investigation. This could also be an issue in the longer run. For example, if you're having seasonal spikes, it's best to have your data lasting longer. Squeezing the best out of a data chunk could be hard and tricky, and this is where the filters are coming handy. You need to be tagging your data as much as possible to enable you to filter not only for a timeline, but maybe a version, an important configuration, or something else. This will enable you to find the similarities and also differences between metrics and help you find the root cause easier. I've separated monitoring into two sections today, system resource metrics and database metrics. I'll be starting with system resource monitoring and CPU usage. Monitoring the performance of your database is crucial. Your database could be using CPU in an unexpected way, but high CPU usage alone won't help us find the reason behind it, so we need to investigate further. One way to start investigation could be checking pgstat activity. It's great if you have already set up your monitor for your connections. Here, total number of connections could tell you if you have leaking connections or not, because each one comes with resource consumption. Another point could be the number of connections for each state. It's good to check how many active, idle in transaction, or idle connections you have. It helps us find if your connections are actively executing queries. And also checking the logs is a good idea. This helps finding if one of the queries is stuck waiting for exclusive log. Disk monitoring and alerts on disk usage is always needed. The most important disk monitoring task of a database administrator is to make sure that the disk doesn't become full. If you somehow run out of storage, you will not have data corruption, but it might prevent useful activity from occurring. So it's necessary to have alerts to notify you on maybe about 90% of disk usage, which will allow you some time to scale or investigate your disk usage increase. This server in particular has a rapid increase in disk usage. It's not in any critical stage, maybe it's just a lot of running queries. Vol files are the transaction logs of Postgres, and using the vol files, you can restore the database back to its state at any previous point in time. Increased disk size could sometimes occur because of vol files. That's why monitoring vol size is another good approach. For the server in particular with a disk size increase, this was a status of the vol size. It's increasing in the same trend. So this explains why we need to check our vol mechanism. This may not always be the case, but it's a good metric to be aware of and maybe set alerts for. The reason behind the increase may be the archive command is not working properly and the vol files are getting piled up, or there are some inactive replication slots left over from disconnected standbys. This could cause your database to build up vol files. These are all warnings for you, for us to take an action. Database performance problems are sometimes caused by high I/O. This means the database is spending more time on either writing or reading from the disk. This is also a good metric to watch out, and high I/O could be caused by bad indexing, partitioning, or checkpoints. Memory is another top metric that we should be aware of. Because the reason is simple. If your database runs out of memory, it may crash. The thing to keep in mind here that you should be aware of the average memory use of your database so that you can set alerts on anomalies and sudden spikes. There are some specific metrics that we want to be aware of. Cached memory, committed memory, dirty memory, and available memory. These are all system resources, and it's good exercise to watch out and have monitoring for all these metrics. Moving on to database monitoring. For query performance, some queries cannot really hold up database performance. That's why you need to look out for long-running or slow Postgres queries, as well as understand how they are executed and how they affect database performance. The pgstat statements extension records statistics for all SQL queries running in the database. It's one of the most important extensions that can be used to detect performance problems. It allows us to obtain information such as total elapsed time, number of rows, execution count for each query run in the database. It is nice to have transaction stats in your dashboards as a summary, just in case you need to check how your database is performing in terms of insert, update row counts, and total commits. And for backups, in case you have run out of space for your database, to save your database, you will need your backups. So not to have a Postgres shutdown crisis, you may want to add your backup health information to your dashboards. This could be storing the date of the latest backup and how many backups you have and your backup retention time. The logs are the best place to look for while debugging issues. They contain lots of information, say server configurations, performance, recovery, checkpoints, and everything else. Considering all the other metrics and alerts we talked about, if you receive an alert regarding resource metrics, this will give you an early indication that there is something wrong with the database, which will prompt you to analyze further the situation and take a look at the logs. This can help you respond to errors thrown by the database before they lead to more serious problems. Make sure you log in all the state changes and operations on your system. Investigating logs could be time-consuming if you don't have a summarization tool defined. Logs have certain error types, and it will be a good approach to have the count of each log and their error types. For example, how many times your database received a certain log in a certain timeline. If you have high CPU incident or need to check how long your last checkpoint lasted, it will be good to have this kind of summarization method. So what's different for Citus? Citus is an extension to Postgres, which you are able to distribute your database across multiple nodes and parallelize the queries and transactions. So it means that the points we have discussed so far is totally valid and needed for Citus. But also we need to be aware of the balance between our nodes. Citus performs best if it's evenly distributed. So having 5 gigabits of data in one node and 300 gigabits for another one could cause degrade in performance and also miss the point of having a distributed database. Another point to keep in mind is the node connectivity. If somehow any of the workers become unreachable, we need to be able to have an alert on this and troubleshoot what happened on this node in particular. I will now mention a customer case regarding node balancing. We got an alert saying that one of the nodes in a server group is about to reach full disk size. Our customers can create alerts on their resources by themselves, and they also receive similar notices. We reached out to the customer and warned them about their specific worker node almost reaching its full capacity. Here is the status of their worker node and its capacity. It's almost reaching the full size. Here is the status of the other worker. It's visible that they're certainly unbalanced and they have almost all their data on worker zero. Later, we continued monitoring the status of workers and it was still an increasing trend. We made another warning on their workers saying that if no action is taken to rebalance or storage increase, their node will be unavailable due to running out of space. And the next day, we received an alert from our monitors that the database became unavailable, and this time the customer reached out to us. This is a situation we were trying to avoid most of the time, and after recovering their node, they scaled out their storage size. And here is the status of their worker after increasing their storage to 2 terabytes. We talked about all the important points and metrics and what we should include in our dashboards. But how do we connect these? You need to be aware of the triggers of your system. Either it's a code change during a deployment or a new configuration for your database, or just a slow running query, your dashboards should enable you to dig deeper on the events and help find the root cause of the issues. I tried to share information I've learned regarding monitoring and troubleshooting on the issues for your database. There is also another talk by Josephine Bosch called Handle Azure PostgreSQL Auditing with Ease. Make sure you don't miss that one as well. Hope you're enjoying Citus Con. Thank you.